Welcome back. So let's have a look at our current state. Let's try something. First, let's just try and log in via SSH. Get enforce is permissive. So let's set enforce 1. And SSH my login user at net kb info now. That doesn't seem to work, does it? Seems we're hanging. Why is that? I'll search MAVCTS recent. So let's just try and fix that stuff. It's early, so going to be making mistakes. Some small things that we should see if we can fit those in. For example, we have some issues with truck. Where it's reading it there. The same for Sisyphus. Shouldn't actually be needed. Then we have some other issues where devlog, where it's trying to log. But let's see if this gets us anywhere. it still doesn't. Strange, because previously it worked fine. Oh, we have a deer open, and that same should probably be for. So we'll just also allow it to list the deers. So we're opening it. Just trying to get as little as possible. 8:31, still no go. Let's have a look. Attributes of the password file and find the syslog. That's basically all it is. So let's see if we have something in tail. CTC get attribute. Mission denied. That's strange. Have a look. Get and set terminal attributes. So, SE module, DB, seems some directory access is night. And we are at 33 right now. Yep, I see something. We have an IO control for dev PTS. Let's add it to allow this. We need to basically keep a mind on keep an eye on what we allow here currently. Def BTS. So here, this IO controls don't audit it. So let's just see if that it's that. May also be related to LSPCI. We're in. So that's actually something that we need to allow. So I'm going to remove this don't audit rule, which I got from upstream, which doesn't make sense. Save that. And this is the deal for love. Secure. Seems fine. No more TC. Get attribute to avoid log messages. Seems fine. And then I'll search 1835. Yeah, this seems to be it, except that we probably want to at least for now get rid of devlog. Where did we So here we have that added socket. We should probably just go inside that first block bubble. Just keep this devlog t sock file. Right. Class sock file. So this is our stuff. Now currently we just don't have access to a lot of stuff in the home directory. Now currently we don't see that because there's nothing there, at least You have this SSH dir, which we do have access to, and we have bash, but there are no cache config, local share, and stuff like that, and no pulse audio, stuff like that, because we can't basically operate on those. So let's browse a little bit around. Permission denied. Permission denied. What's this? It's also not allowed. Got etc password. DF free. Oh, free actually works. Top doesn't show anything. PS aux doesn't show anything. So that looks pretty restricted. Let's just get out of here. Works. So in the 4C mode we have a pretty restricted SSH user. Now there's a lot of AVC denials though, if you look now, because we don't audit stuff, and as you can see currently there's just many things it's trying to do, but it's getting blocked at the first attempt. So from that point of view, it's pretty confined. But this works. Well, let's have a look at, and it's 41 currently. We need to make sure that we're clean. See how if we can make the local login work. So let's just wait for 42. It's 42 currently. All right, so we're clean. Let's see if we can make local login work. So I'll send a key. My login user. And it actually also works. Let's see what AVC denials we're getting here for by just logging in. These are all don't audit it. So that's great. Seems great. Yeah, it is great actually. So basically, both the console login both the console login as well as the SSH login works currently out of the box. So that's fine, that's great. And we don't have much stuff. So that's a big improvement. Can't access them. And that's fine. Although some programs will not work that way. Exit. Let's send a FN. Yeah, so we're back. So we have SSH working confined, and we have console working confined. And I mean really confined. It's just far more confined than the current guest domain. And yeah, then you can this is basically a base, so you can basically extend that by using booleans or not even booleans, just extend it. But we're trying to basically get as little permissions as possible. So now I know it would be tempting to actually try and log in from TDM, but my gut feeling says that we're not ready. That we just should first try a few times in permissive mode. So set enforce 0, and then N, not M. So we're clean. Let's just try and log in permissive mode with SE module DB. So it logs everything, so we need to be careful. I don't see any SE troubleshoot. We're still clean there. And it almost actually just seems clean, almost. But that's just the first try. We need to really try this a couple times. So first things first. We have here a small block of policy that's related. I am so guess. Yep, search. And let's just move this to the right place. It needs a search cache before it can get to. We have here config home dir. Let's just add this there. One line. Now we can remove this one, keep it a little bit more compact. So here is what's happening. Okay. else do we have? We have a get attribute of temp, third errors, and search for a spool. Spoolty. Or is it spoolty? It's for spoolty and tempty. Get attribute of tempty. We probably just need some access to tempty though. So let's require some types here. For spool and tempty. Type for spool t temp. And that's netlink a password file. We're trying to avoid that. Not sure if we're going to be able to do that. And that's basically it so far. So let's see again. If in the meanwhile anything changed. Seem to have changed much, if anything. Let's also see if we now have some debus related stuff. Also no debus related stuff. Okay, then just log out and see what happens. We have updates without AVC denials. Odd. Log off. Still no audit messages. Let's see if we have anything new out of the ordinary. No, nothing. So let's just try and build and install this. And without removing the actual DIRS, log in again and have a look again. And the same we're going to use the same times as before. As to that we don't overlook that we're not overlooking something. Now, let's do this again. So we still don't have these. Let's see what we have now. HDM stuff, and we're trying to avoid those. Now here, we're getting some new stuff. Here we have some new stuff. That we need to implement. And it's again IAM settings. So we need to go to the accessing part. And I'll just paste these here for now and then just fit them in. So cache home does search, but it also wants to actually add a file there. Cache home does, cache home t does. And we have a file that's created there. And we have a get attribute of config home tdirs. So that's get attribute of config home tdirs. And that's this stuff, get attribute of config home tdirs. Let's go back, see what else we have. That's it. Let's see if there are user AVC denials. None. Let's log out. Let's first build. We are having some classes that are not for file. Let's go back. So what it's saying. Yeah, that doesn't make sense. And I just search there. Ouch. This is not nice. This is not good. We made a mess here. Let's get attribute allow this, get attribute search. Right, remove 9. Let's have a look back. What it was, what it actually was. Because we weren't So it's the moon. This was already allowed, so do we add, we should just add that to those, and then remove that from. Let's just keep it this way. We were sleepy heads and doing the wrong thing. It happens, it's still early, it's 9 o'clock in the morning. Still having the morning coffee. So yeah. Things can go wrong. Things will go wrong. Log off. Well yeah, that's also a good, or at least it's not really good, but so XDM is hanging. Try that again. XDM appends executing a shell, which is probably just a test. XDM read an XDM file. So this might actually, not sure. We'll see later. GNOME shell, trying to get trying to get to a binary file which we should take care of. And that my login user, let's see, that's not this one. XDM, XDM, hostname. Rename, write, create, and link, and then so let's do it. This is for a file. Rename, write, create, and link. And then we have this get attribute of imset config home. And we haven't actually. Yeah, imset config home, and that is a dir. So imset config home dir is get attribute. What else do we have? Nothing. Nothing that strange. So let's allow that. need to make sure that the base is solid, and that requires just a lot of work, because else if you don't have a solid base, then you start mixing up things that are base and not base. That's not nice. You really want to have some point where you can say, okay, this is now done, and whatever comes now is just not something that's basic. Nothing new here. Nothing new there. Nothing new there. Let's just log out again and clear the directory. Oh, log in again first. And then log out and clear the directory, and then start over again. That don't make sense. Oh, that's user agency. XDM. Login user session XDM. Now this one will should probably just allow this one. And we should also have a look at this shell execute. But we're not there yet, I think. Let's see. Yeah, we have now currently the rules for the user, so that's fine now. But let's just allow that GNOME shell, G shell. Let's just allow this here. Just allow this one. Just don't append the get attribute. And then maybe open later. It's the home key. That install it. Oh yeah, and we should also have a look at what executing it now again. Seems that GNOME keeps executing grab execute. GNOME session is executing that GNOME shell, Nautilus connect server. So we need to take care of that. Where is Nautilus Connect server? Where is Nautilus Connect? So that's basically checking everything that it depends on. But we just need to take care of this one as well. FC, just add that below. And then call it Naut CS. And then go here all the way below and just add the same stuff for Naut CS. Naut CS. This is not checking for nothing. It's checking because it's going to be bound to be using it somehow. And there's more coming where there's more where this came from. There's this. Oh. Yeah, notes. See ya. Yeah, there's a stuff load of dependencies. Where is G shell? Then where we have the other checks. We need to add that check. Do we have that check? Yeah. So basically, I'm just going to expand this. Naut CS exactly and EO G exactly. And I'll just add test now, but it's not what I mean with test. It's basically that. So that I know that these are the things. I forgot the plan. Close this one. And then you'll probably see that it's going to be onto the next. There's going to be more. Okay, so log off. Oh, actually, first make sure that you also actually restore Connet. Else it's going to be hanging on the same thing again. Now log off. The weird thing is with package manager, it's really odd. Actually grab execute, that's not Nautilus Connect server, Nautilus Connect server is old. So you see, this stuff keeps popping up, as you can see. This one, contacts, case. So decon cert provider, contact cert provider. So decon cert P, and this was cache home T the search. So this is here search. Yeah. What else do we have? Better take your time and I thought we actually also allowed to read. We did. They actually am read. So that's some error somewhere else. XDM wants to execute it now as well, so grab XDM, grab execute, and then audit to allow R, and then my XDM TE. Then do that again and install it. So now XDM also wants to execute it because we gave it a private type, the Nautilus Connect server. Okay, we were logged out off, let's log in again. Let's go through it again. Test it a couple times. Don't get ahead of yourself. This is allowed. This is XDM that you should probably ignore. And we're having a UDEF foreign T4 DSET. So where is DZD? So UDEF. UDEF RNT. It's already doing something there. So let's see what we have for UDEF. A search, and that also makes sense. Read search. These are things that just make sense. And again, we have a GNOME shell execute. So we're going to have a bunch of GNOME shell executes now. And those are all the apps that it's going to need to do its thing. about it. Oh yeah, this is loud, so we're done there. So we're going to do again that exact stuff. And look for GNOME shell. And here we have it, transmission to decay. So where is transmission to decay? And then the same idea again, over and over again. Where is user game transmission to decay? And hopefully at some point it will just stop trying to get to all these files. Transmission GTK, long type, but okay. Transmission GTK, so we're going to do the same thing again. Transmission GTK, and then probably GDM wants it also. Transmission GTK, not sure why. Transmission GTK, just copy this over, it goes hella quicker. Then where is G shell and add that. Where are we here? Just add that in there. In the list of stuff that it's trying to work with. And then build that again. Patience is a virtue. Then restore clone the path. Don't forget that. Restore clone. And on to the next. There's more. There's more. Log off. Have a look. Probably XDM also want to execute it. This all looks fine and dandy. We have keyring daemon also reading get attribute of GDM XDM. And Tuckmanworth has actually a lot of it now, needs it. So maybe we should just allow that. But first things first. grep, execute grep transmission DTK. Then audit to allow R and my XDM TE. And we should just deal with this stuff here. I'll just deal with this stuff. Because I don't like don't audits, and I don't see the problem here. So XDM home T. This one here. Copy that one. Where is XDMT? We can remove this one. Where is XDMT? So let's just change this to T shell T, and then just have a look at. And I'll just grep for now. Just grep XDM home T, and then grep get attribute. I'm just going to add them for everything that wants to get attribute. So data dipmon, where is data dipmon? Going to add that as well. And then Deya de Mon. Back. We have G shell already took care of that. Track minor FS, TR minor FS, and TR store. Where is TR minor FS? Just add it somewhere here. TR minor FS and TR store. TR store. And just get that there as well. TR store. Right. And then just build that. Install it. Then just see what else XDM or GNOME shell wants to execute. And then see, try to get everything that XDM is trying to execute, get that confined. And it just makes sense. You'll see later. Let's see, we're logged off. It just makes sense to do that. Keyring diamond. DM. And that's this one, and then use that for gnome queuing daemon as well. GKRD. Okay. This is all done. This is allowed. Shell executing. Let's go. Oh, and here we have trans. Oh, that's loud, yeah. So let's just go ahead and do that execute dance again, because we know. Like, gnome shell probably is trying to execute something else again. Yep. Gnome system monitor. So that's the next one. Oh, and the first. Where is these are just all dependencies that we really need to deal with, basically all those things that GNOME just needs but not right now. These sysm, gsysm, sysmon. Yes. All the way below. Copy this one. GSysmon, and then just copy that over and use that. We need to confine all these. Really, just not now. We just need to make sure that we can deal with GNOME. So where is G shell? And then go ahead and find it. So G sysmon. Actually add that in there. G sysmon. Exactly. Save and exit. Build that again, install it. And log off. Oh, actually, let's just restore from the sysmon. Need to really do that, else I'm wasting time. And I don't like wasting time because this is taking a long time as is. Let's see if XDM executes this. Probably. So what do we have? This is now allowed. This is allowed. This is allowed. This is allowed. And here's DMT again. that's loud, that's loud, that's loud. This is a loud, that's loud as well. And here we have the sysmon. We need to allow XEM. Basically, Jesus, man. And install that. Basically, whatever does this, oh, that actually it's GNOME shell that does it. So I guess somehow the same logic that is in GNOME shell is also in whatever runs in XDM. Okay, log in again. See what else it wants. Because probably if any of these programs aren't there, then GNOME shell might just crap out. Who knows? Reads appends, reads appends. This is allowed. Getting a little bit messy. We have here something interesting. There is G shell init warranty, and we already had something related to init warranty, didn't we? Thought we did. So I'll just allow a get attribute here as well. I thought we already had something, but that's probably someone something else. So and then do the execute dance again because you know it. Basically it's going to do it all. And we're going to have to deal with it all. going to try all the programs that it basically relies upon. See if it's there. And if it's not there, then who knows what it will do. But yeah, we just need to basically be there and do it. Okay. Going to be like 10 or 20 different applications that we're going to have to go through it. Sucks, but well, I'm going to 9:40. Now with the ABC denials. So that some of this old stuff is removed, because it makes me a little bit dizzy. Okay, so it's that XDM stuff again, it was expected. Ouch. Nano. My XDM key actually doesn't really matter, but still. Oh, it does matter. This actually allows. That does matter. So basically we have GNOME Shell running in XDM. Actually can't do that. So fuck that. I just need to think when I need to think. On to the next. But compared to GNOME 2, this is rather clean. And we have here Pulse Audio searching temp fast. So good thing that we keep testing this. allowing that attribute. Get attribute. Makes sense. But we need to basically require the type. Makes sense. And that basically goes for each and every program. So basically, that goes for each and every program, this stuff. So what we're going to do is pulse audio temp fs, search for it, and then just allow each domain that acts on it, allow that pulse audio temp fs. This is the first one. Then here we're going to allow this one for DZD. Oh, actually, it's already there. Just search and get attribute, add to it. Search, get attribute. Next. Search, get attribute, next, search, get attribute, next, search, actually, I need to start thinking, search, get attribute. Don't do anything without thinking. Because whenever there's some routine, involved. That's weird. Okay. And then back again on to the next. Exact. There you did. Where is the user bin? Yeah. Where is the shell? They are the exactly. Make that. Install it. Restore connet. Actually, check this because there seems to be something alright here. This might be a link. Another link. Okay, so we still call it. Okay, log off. Go to this stuff again and again and again and again. There we have that XDM again. So now the dub, but I'll only take the last one 50, and I'll also check 950. But I'll also check. Takes the right one. It's the end. Yeah. And then on to the next. So in theory, until everything is done, We have some more. So you this month. It's also searching in foreign too. Also take care of the other search stuff. Okay, that's a good search. Okay, that's a good search. Although it does probably doesn't need that, but save and sorry. And stupid execute. What's next? File roller. Where is file roller? Where is file? Roller. 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 These are just some basic programs that Shell depends upon or relies upon. It's not just basically checking everything user bin, it's just checking the stuff that it wants to make sure that it's there, I guess. Going to do that because I know this is just simply the shell running in the XDN domain. So, and this is just something that's in the shell, GNOME shell. Dang. God damn it. Yeah, Ghent. Jesus Christ. I hate that. Restore confile roller. It's quite annoying this, but you need to stay cool and just be persistent and go on and do it. That's basically the main story with all this stuff. Be persistent, do it. You also need to know what you do, so it's easier said than done. Gnome shell, grab, execute, what's next? You gotta be kidding me. Yeah, I'm not. I need to log in. It's coming, don't worry. No need to worry. It's coming. Don't believe me? Well, have a look here. Nautilus. Where is Nautilus? Where is Nautilus? Another dependency. The nice thing is that this does give us an opportunity to test thoroughly. New line. And then go back and then do the XDM here because, well, don't forget to restore Chrome-based bus. And log off. And go all over it again. Take a new time now. Five, and should be taking a break soon. It looks clean. One more run. One more command to do. What's it this time? Baobab. Where is Baobab? Been Baobab. I know what it is. It's the last one for this run because this probably won't stop for a little while. So these are the apps we just really need to confine. Although it doesn't actually run them, it does give us the notification that these should at least work. So that's basically the first stuff we need to focus on. We have the base going on. Where is G shell? Go on to the line. Let's paste that in. Baobab exec. Go back. Edit my VM. Make F install and restore Baobab. And then we're going to take a break. I'm going to log off. And then I'm going to take a break. And I actually restore Chrome. I'm going to also clear some stuff. Log off first, so that we have a clean slate Oh God. And then it's basically kill all because I'm probably having a lot of my login user, and then it's clear my login user shell, and then lshz temp, a lot of stuff here. It's actually the only one. Odd, but good, fine. Okay, so take a break.